20th anniversary, it came to my great good fortune to commission a new work. And if you know anything about sort of bringing music to life for the very first time, it is exciting, it's scary, it's expensive, right? And we were so fortunate to have a major donor come forward, and that enabled us to create the next piece for you. I reached out to a colleague of mine, Dr. Dominick DiOrio, to write a song for us, which he agreed, but of course we had to find a text that would be appropriate. And I reached out to my dear friend Linnell, who's the artistic director of the Oakland Youth Chorus, and I said, do you have any inspiration? Do you have any thoughts? And she in fact did. She said, we have a poet in the Oakland Youth Chorus that writes pieces, that writes poetry. Maybe Dominick would like to look at some of those. And so Eleanor sent me some stuff, and I sent them to Dominick, and then they worked magic, and a song was written, and then we learned it, and now we're about to perform it for you. So now you can all. We hear a lot about text. For me, the text of the song is really the heart of the song, and the music is that which brings the text to life. And I wonder, when we listen to vocal music in our world, how much do we actually think about the text? I don't listen to pop music, so maybe on the radio people think about text. I don't know. Does Taylor Swift think about text?
Yes.
Yeah, that's right. Well, we do. And so I want to make sure that we share with you this sort of bridging of two art forms, the poetry and the music. And so to help illuminate that, I'm excited to welcome to the stage, to recite the poem before we sing it, the poet herself, Eleanor Wikstrom.
Feeling infinite against the dying sky.